We have sought to know the history of the past 400 years of racial injustice. We have called the church to own that story before God with the heart of lament. Now we must resolve to change the story and to write a new narrative together. We must begin in the places of greatest historic inequalities by acting with justice towards our African American brothers and sisters and by loving and serving them in their community. We must honor and receive their gifts and contributions as equal partners. Though in the past they have been degraded and exploited, we ought to work together to honor, elevate, and esteem all they have to offer. But we need not stop there. We must embrace the message that all cultures and races bear the Imago Dei, the image of our Creator, and that His glory is revealed in each and every human. We, the church, must resolve to lead the way in affirming the dignity of all human life. We must be courageous in showing love, not just to our neighbors, but even to those that would oppose us. The church must demonstrate the inherent value of all people, regardless of culture, race, gender, or economic status. This is how we change the story. In Micah 6:8, the prophet says, "He has shown you, O man, what is good and what the Lord requires of you, to do justly, to love mercy, and to walk humbly with God." We charge you today to take up your part in changing the story. Refuse to be complacent in the face of injustice and be the change, one conversation, one interaction, one life at a time. Ultimately, we know the end of the story. One day we will experience perfect unity as people from every nation, tongue, and tribe, worshiping our God and Savior around the heavenly throne. But let's not wait to taste heaven's realities. Let's bring that love, justice, beauty, and worship in every place God sends us. Así que te bendigo, Dios te bendiga, Dios haga resplandecer su rostro sobre ti y te dé paz.